Union speech. Joining us to talk about that is Republican Congressman Adam Kinzinger of Illinois. Congressman Kinzinger, this memo causing quite a split between Republican and Democratic lawmakers. Is it your view that the public should see this? And based on what you've seen, is there anything disturbing in this memo?
I'm very cautious in how I talk about it. A lot of people have said a lot of things on the memo. It's top secret as of this moment. I have read it. There are concerning things in it that it seems like people are going to have an opportunity to see, and then they can make their own judgments. One of the things we need to be very careful of is disparaging the FBI, for instance. They're a great organization with fantastic Americans, but if there's something that comes out, if it does, that deserves concern or a second look, we should do it. And I think the good news is the American people are going to have an opportunity to make a determination for themselves instead of right and left fighting in front of the cameras.
You're very aware that the president himself is in the midst of an ongoing attack on the FBI, portraying it in very strong terms as being in tatters, as being biased. Very public comments. And other Republican lawmakers, your colleagues, supporting him in those charges. This memo, it appears, part of that broader assault on the FBI. Is it your view that this memo somehow gives evidence to that charge, that the FBI as an institution is biased against this president?
I want to wait till the memo is declassified because I'm very sensitive about talking about anything that is classified as secret or top secret. What I will say is if this is in fact declassified, people will have an opportunity to read it and come to a conclusion on their own. There are some that say this is the end of the world and some that say this is nothing. It's probably somewhere in between that. And it seems like we're going to have the opportunity, people are going to have the opportunity to read it. One of the things that I wish we could get back to is to where, you know, we could just talk about these issues, have a good discussion without necessarily arguing it, without anybody knowing all the details of everything. Yeah, hopefully we'll know something soon.
Sad fact, and you know as well as me, that we're nowhere near that place you're describing.
Right. Yeah.
Let me just ask you, because these are issues close to your heart. Do you believe the FBI is institutionally biased against this president?
I believe the FBI is made of great people. And just like, for instance, in the military, somebody could express a like to Donald Trump. That doesn't make the military there to support Donald Trump. It means that people within an institution can have political opinions. We're Americans. We all have political opinions. So I think we have to be careful to say there may be individuals associated with certain things that should be held accountable, absolutely, versus saying a whole institution. I have a good friend I flew in the Air Force with that's an FBI agent now, and great folks in the FBI doing the Lord's work every day.
We're learning more about the president's speech tonight, and one of those is that he's going to make, in the words of an administration official, eye-opening remarks on North Korea. Do you expect that there will be a threat issued from the president? What is your view of the president's posture towards North Korea? And he has, as you know, in public comments, threatened military action.
Well, I think when I hear eye-opening, and I don't know, I haven't read the president's speech or talked to him about it, but I think maybe in terms of showing the American people exactly where North Korea is and the reality of the threat. And the fact that if we accept a nuclear North Korea, you by definition will have to accept a nuclear Iran and any other regime at that point that decides they're going to get nuclear weapons. You'll have thrown out the nuclear non-proliferation treaty, in essence. And so this is an awful moment. There's no doubt about it. But this is like kind of 1938 Europe, where we're sitting here making a decision of, are we going to confront this evil? Hopefully we can do it peacefully. And so I actually imagine the president's going to talk a lot about what North Korea's really doing. And so we'll see.
The CIA director you heard in an interview with the BBC say today that Russia continues to interfere in U.S. elections, and he expects very much that they will do so in the 2018 midterms. Do you believe that this president, President Trump, has done enough to prevent future and ongoing attacks by Russia on election systems?
Well, I think we always need to do more, and that includes the president. Part of the way to inoculate against this outside interference is to make people aware of it and to admit it, so that if you get on a social media platform and you see a news feed or a news story that appears outrageous, you now learn to accept that it probably is outrageous and not real. So I think there's a lot more we can do. I know Mike Pompeo well. I served with him on the Energy and Commerce Committee. I know he's on top of this and very concerned, and I think the administration's very concerned about it. But I think talking about this in the open and public is actually the first step to really defending against it.
But I have to ask you a question. You have a president who is accusing our network and other networks of fake news when there is actual real fake news being planted by Russia for political effect. How can the country mount a credible defense when the president is in effect, you know, mixing charges against Russia with charges against members of the American media?
Well, he says what he says. I believe that there's legitimate fake news out there, and legitimate fake news is stuff like what you see on RT, Russian Today, Russian television. You see these KGB or FSB farms basically retweeting posting on Facebook these stories. So it's a real problem. I'm not going to look. There's a lot of things the president tweets that I wouldn't tweet. I'm very open about that. But the first thing we need to do as Americans is be aware that when you get on Facebook or something and you see a story that's too crazy to be true, chances are it probably is.
Congressman Kinzinger, thanks very much.
Anytime.